श्रीमान् वेङ्कटनाथार्य कविथार्किकेसरि वेदान्ताचार्यवर्यो मे सन्निधत्तां सदा हृदि. विल् कण्टिन्यू टु एञ्जाय् स्वामी यामुनाचार्यस् वण्डर्फुल् स्तोत्ररत्न श्लोकम्स्. टुडेस् वर्स् इस् नम्बर् 21. इस् अ ग्रेट् वर्स् अबौट् सो फार् स्वामी टाक्ड् अबौट् द परत्वं, द सौलभ्यत्वं, సౌశీల్యత్వం, ద ఎంజాయ్మెంట్ దట్ హీ గ్రాంట్స్ అస్, ద మోక్షానుభవం, ద సంకల్పం టు గెట్ అస్ రిడ్ ఆఫ్ అవర్ సంసారిక్ అఫ్లిక్షన్స్ అండ్ ద కర్మ వాసనాస్, అండ్ హెన్స్ హీ క్రియేట్స్ దిస్ యూనివర్స్ త్రూ చతుర్ముఖ బ్రహ్మ, బ్రింగ్స్ అవుట్ ద జీవాత్మ ఫ్రమ్ ద కాస్మిక్ డిసల్యూషన్, ఎస్టాబ్లిషస్ ద శాస్త్రాస్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ హిస్ పరమ కారుణ్యం అండ్ దయా. Through sages, he establishes the Sanatana Dharmam. He sends the Alvars and the Acharya Purushas for the sake of us, to uplift us, to save us from the samsaric afflictions as part of his protection. Thinking of these, Alavandar now desires for getting rid of the samsaric afflictions and the karmic diseases. He and wants to attain moksha, and thus he wishes to take the path of Sharanagati, refuge at his lotus feet, with an apprehension and terrible fear about the excruciating agony of samsaram, samsara sagaram, feeling utterly remorseful for his own past, regretting his past, with utter helplessness, akinchanyam, realizing Swami Sriman Narayana's paratvam, along with sausilya, vatsalya, saulabhya gunas, knowing that he is the Supreme Lord with ubhaya vibhuti natan, and it is only he who can take from the lila vibhuti to the Nitya Vibhuti, because he owns both the Vibhutis, he owns both the worlds, and he is the one who can grant moksham. Moksham dadati iti mukundaha, none else can be sought after for moksham. Alavandar clearly understood, and he wants us to understand, and that's why he has composed so far, and now he pleads and appeals and prays for removing the virodhis, removing the hurdles, removing the obstacles for performing his path of Sharanagati. And hence, he pays this his obeisance again and again. Namo namo vangmanasati bhumaye, namo namo vangmanasaika bhumaye, namo namo nanta mahavibhutaye, namo namo nanta dayaika sindave. Swami explains, namo namo vangmanasati bhumaye, the one who is beyond the reach of manas, vak, kayam, beyond the reach of speech and mind, mano, vak, beyond the reach of manas, beyond the reach of vak, obeisance to you again and again, namaskarams to you again and again. And secondly, he says, one who is the only object of the same speech and mind. The first line, beyond the reach of speech and mind. Second line, the only object of speech and mind. Obeisance to you again and again. The third line, namo namo ananta mahavibhutaye, one who has infinite greatest powers, the two, one who owns the two worlds, namely this vibhuti and the upper world Nitya Vibhuti, the Leela Vibhuti and the Nitya Vibhuti. Obeisance to you again and again. Namaskarams to you again and again. And finally, namo namo ananta maha dayaika sindave, one who is the personification, repository, storehouse of ocean of compassion, the deep, large, vast ocean of daya. Obeisance to you again and again. Unless he showers his grace, daya, one cannot be the object of the speech and mind. Unless he showers us on the grace, we will not be able to praise him with our speech and mind. So even if one is blessed by his grace, does not mean that the praise, the one who praises will reach the ultimate. No, it is not Purnam. It's not full. He cannot be praised or uttered or understood or comprehended or celebrated, glorified completely, fully comprehending his vaibhavam and glories. But having said that, he is the only sole object of speech and mind. Even though Vedas mention that yato vacho nivartante apraapya manasa saha, where the mind cannot reach, the speech also does not reach. Where the speech does not reach, my mind also does not, and both return back, failing in their mission to accomplish the objective and to fully praise him. The very purpose of our speech and mind is being blessed with such speech and mind, is to praise him and contemplate on him. Praise him and have dhyanam on him. Praise him with our walk and pray and contemplate on him with our mind. Otherwise, complete waste. Like him, we need to also comprehend his two vibhutis quite well. We need to comprehend his Leela Vibhuti and Nitya Vibhuti. And no, it is of course difficult, limitless, unbounded. He is Ubhaya Vibhuti Nathan. Since he is Ubhaya Vibhuti Nathan, since he owns both worlds, it is he who can take from us, from this world to the other world. None else can. So then only our mind will desire to reach the other vibhuti. And for what is the means or the way to reach? Is daya. Dayaika sindoho. What we can do is to offer our pranamams again and again at his feet. So does Alavandar. So now, if Swami explains and glorifies Emperuman's Anubhavam here so beautifully, he is the only one who is beyond mind and speech. He says Namaha, Namaha, Namaha. He has told Namaha so many times. And Namashabdam, Alavandar mentions even numbered Namaha. Namo Namo Vangmanasati Bhumaye, Namo Namo Vangmanasaika Bhumaye, Namo Namo Ananta Mahavibhutaye, Namo Namo Ananta Dayeka Sindave. Alavandar mentioned even number, he mentions four times, twice Namo, eight times, meaning Ashtanga Pranamam to the Lord. Also, the mind, speech and body, all performing pranamams to you again and again. Maybe the interpretation. Also, Namaha, 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 Namastestu, Sahasrakritvaha. Arjunan tells Emperuman, Gitacharyan, in the 11th chapter, Namaha, Namastestu, Sahasrakritvaha. And even Shvetadvipa Vashigal, always they say Namaha, Namaha, and keep their folded hands above their head and say Namaha. And also Shanti Parvam, Mahabharatam, it says Baddhanjali Puta Hrishta Nama Ityeva Vadinaha. And even our Shaunakadi Rishis, it says Jitamte Pundarikaksha Namaste Vishwabhavanaha. And everything they talk about Namaha. Dviste Agre Namaha, Triste Agre Namaha, Asahasra Kritstave Namaha, Asahasra Kritvaste Namaha, Aparimita Kritvaste Namaha, means 1000 times, Aparimita Kritvaste, beyond the number of counts, I am telling you Namaha. Taitri Aranyakam says, all these things are need to be enjoyed and contemplated here, our Acharya mentions in the commentary. And probably Purvangam of the Sharanagati, he says this Namah Shabdam. It could be possible. And Sharanagati should be done only once. But why there are so many times Namaha here? That's because Prataksha, here you cannot equate Sharanagati and this Namaha. Pratakshina Pranamamscha Yugman Yevatu Karayet. Pratakshinam and pranamam should be in even numbers. Alavandar Aj quotes here, and that is why it should be either 2 or should be 4 or should be 8 as per pranamams, as per sastrams. So namaha also can be interpreted as sharanagati, because Veda Vyasa himself equates namaha to sharanagati. Saida Velvian says Swami Namalva. Saida Velvian, after performing sharanagati, he has performed the Velvi, the yagam of sharanagati, Nyasa Vidya, and hence Saida Velvian. Anushtita Krita Satan is the vachanam, is the pramanam for the Saida Velvian. Anushtita Krita Satan. So Ahirbunya Samhita also says Samit Sadhana Khadinam Yajnanam Nyasam Atmanaha Namasa Yokarot Deve Sa Swadvara Itiritaha. Same Pancharatra Samhita also mentions the same mantra, and thus Veda Vyasa mentions that Margandeya advises Panchapandavas that you should perform Sharanagati to Emperuman. Sarveshameva Lokanam Pita Mata Cha Madhavaha Gachatvam Yenam Sharanam Sharanyam Purushar Shabaha. In Vanaparvam, Swami says, Margandeya, sage Margandeya advises Panchapandava, and Yeva Mukta Straya Partha Yamocha Bharatar Shabaha Draupadya Sahita Sarve Namascha Kurja Nardhanam. So Namas is mentioned here, is referred to Sharanagati of Pandavas to Emperuman. This Namas means Namaha is the construction of two letters being two words that forms one sentence. The word Maha means for me. Namaha is not for me. I am not related to me. I and mine are not mine. I am not, it is not mine. So, that way, the activities of mine are not mine. I also do not belong to me. And that is what it means. So, this is the way one should think of Mama. By this reflection, one should think that this ahankara mamakaram, the sense of the I and mine, na ma, na mama, are the roots of samsara. This I and mine are the roots of samsara that should be cut off by saying nama, na mama. I, who am distinct from the non-sentient entity, the body, and is subservient to the Lord alone, of Lord of Shriyapati, Sriman Narayana, he is my master, he is my Seshi. This kind of ahankara, mamakara that are existing are anuguna, are in accordance with the jiva's nature. That is why one should think the perverse ahankara, mamakaram that is pointed out in I, myself, and all that is mine are full of defects and faults. That should be eliminated here. And that is what is saying by nama, nama, nama. Mama also means equivalent to yama. Namama means not having yamaha, means yanade ondrumille. There is nothing that belongs to me. There is nothing which is mine. So, yane yanne ariyagilade, yane yendanade endrinende. யானே நீ என் உடமையும் நீயே வானே ஏத்தும் என் வானவரேரே. திருவாய்மொழி சேஸ், ஆழ்வார் நம்மாழ்வார் மென்ஷன்ஸ் திஸ், அண்ட் சுவாமி ஆச்சாரியா சுவாமி தேசிகன் ரெஃபர்ஸ் டு திஸ் வேர்ஸ் வென் இ டாக்ஸ் அபவுட் வேரியஸ் பிரமாணம்ஸ் ஃபார் திஸ் ஸ்தோத்திர பாஷ்யம். அண்ட் சுவாமி ரெஃபர்ஸ் டு எக்ஸ்பிளனேஷன் ஆஃப் நம, டேக்கிங் ஆல் தீஸ் ரெஃபரன்சஸ். அண்ட் ஹென்ஸ் தென் கம்ஸ் Ananta Mahavibhutaye, this Leela and Nitya Vibhuti are completely false. The whole Jagan Mithya is all completely brushed aside by saying Ananta Mahavibhutaye. This Leela Vibhuti and the Nitya Vibhuti are completely endless. The Leela Vibhuti has got no, has got the lower bound, has got the upper boundary but not lower. The Nitya Vibhuti has got lower boundary but not upper. Since it is only due to your Daya, one can get rid of this samsaric afflictions and go to Nitya Vibhuti. Please bless us. Ananta Dayaika Sindave. This Daya Guna is much, much grander than the other Kalyana Gunas. And you may, Perumal Sriman Narayana, you may have Jnana Bhakti, Jnana Bhakti, Aishwaryam, Viryam, Tejas, Balam, all these six Gunas. But without this Daya Guna, nothing would be valid. Anuchara Saktyadi Guna, Agre Sarabhodi Virajita Lokam, Sri Daya Sataka Stotram. In that, he says, Dosha Bhave Yurete Iti Yati Nama Daye Twaya Vina Bhutaha. Without this Daya Guna, what would the other Gunas? They will all become doshams for you, Sriman Narayana. So please shower your grace. Only due to your grace, one can get rid of samsaric world. Please bless me so. And thus, I offer my pranams. Namo namo vangmanasati bhumaye. Namo namo vangmanasaika bhumaye. Namo namo ananta mahavibhutaye. Namo namo ananta dayaika sindave. Namo narayana. Kavitarkika simhaya kalyana gudasharine. Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha.